They're calling to cancel.
Well, I'm still at work, but if you need to chat, bring it off.
Look, I'm gonna need you to come by the cabin. Bring your kit.
Sure, I can come out tomorrow. I'm off rotation for the rest of the week.
Nah, that's gotta be tonight.
Jesus, Frank, what the hell do you do?
Just need some medical attention.
Go to the emergency room. There's nothing to be embarrassed about.
Not an option. Thanks, Carl.
I'm fine, Carl.
You tell me to come all the way up here. Now you're fine?
It's not for me.
I'm gonna need a damn good explanation for this.
I was hunting down that buck. I heard a sound in the distance and saw a man dumping something in a ditch. She's the something. Trouble spots on her hip.
Get my bag.
What do you want me to do?
I've got it from here.
Can I get one of those? Thanks, I'm gonna smoke.
Oh, you quit.
I did. I think this qualifies as a special circumstance.
You know, my grandpa stowed his smokes in this tin.
Hit him in the exact same spot in the woodpile.
Scale of 1 to 10, how fucking stupid are you? Someone dumps a body in the woods, and your first instinct is to take her home and put her in her bed? You gotta take her to a hospital. Go to the police.
Oh, so the sheriff could take down her statement? How many flights of stairs she fell down, send her right back to him? Well, he beats the daylights out of his own goddamn wife.
You gotta cover your ass here. This shit doesn't look good. Anyone else comes up here, you'll be weighing down a Cottage County.
Carl?
What?
I'll handle it. And if I do need you, I'll let you know.
Okay. Later on, when I'm telling you I told you so, I want you to remember this. Just to change the subject, Kelly wants you to meet a friend of hers from work. From what she says, this Kylie's pretty funny. Talks a lot. She says it'll be a perfect match. Opposites attract and what have you.
Yeah.
I'm not inviting you. I'm informing you that you'll be attending. For whatever reason, my wife likes you and wants you to be happy. I'll admit, it doesn't make a lick of sense to me. Look, Frank. I know we've seen a lot of awful shit together. I can't let you move out here and quit. I left a couple bandages inside, change it in the morning, and she starts to run a fever. Let me know.
Make you ride back to your truck?
No, I'll walk. Thanks for the beer.
Thank you. Nor will there be. You know, we've heard a lot about it over the generations, but it seems like there are more people suffering from the disorder than ever.
Well, in past wars, it was referred to as shell shock. It wasn't referred to as PTSD. That wasn't even a term or acknowledged until recently. Soldiers of past generations had a higher mortality rate when deployed in combat zones. You just simply didn't have the survival rate you did now with modern medicine, new techniques. Soldiers going out into active war zones actually have a chance to come back, and now that's what we're stuck dealing with. We have a problem. We have a large population of soldiers coming back, and we just don't know how to treat it.
That's an interesting way to look at it. So the world being less dangerous actually has a heightened effect in the stress of a modern soldier. Let's go to the phones and get your opinions. We have Mary on the line from Newfield. Mary, what are your thoughts on this discussion?
Thank you. Did I tell you what he did? Yeah, he's making us wear fucking bow ties and matching sweaters. It's awful. It's terrible. I look completely wrecked. Hold on one second. Hi, can I help you?
You get one for Disco Friday.
Okay, that's $8. Hold on. There you go. Here's your ticket.
Hello, please. Always wrong to protect me.
Well, I may not run much well, but you can always count on me. She'll need you very much, Mr. Burns. I aim to do most of the protecting myself.
Burns, telephone.
For me? That's strange. Pardon me. You know, he's not such a bad fellow.
No, you should make some girl feel happy.
I'm happy. He's not good enough for you, I can see that, but I sort of like him. He's got a lot of charm.
When he comes back naturally, his grandfather
doesn't think. Hello? Hello? Hey, Delbert. Listen, if there's any way we can stop the 4 o'clock train to Albany from leaving town.
Hey, Dad, that's fine.
Thanks, Tom.
Sorry about that, that's silly. Listen, really sorry, let me get that straight. I must have misunderstood you. You mean you're taking the sleep of the day and then getting mad?
Well, this must be a special occasion. What'll it be?
Cheap beer and a whiskey.
How's your father doing these days?
I haven't seen him in over a year.
I saw him down at the BFW, cheering on his little league team. He still has a bit of fire to him.
That's why we haven't spoken in a while.
How was your problem tonight? You know who that is? You say that I do, why?
That asshole is Frank Olson. Henry Olson's little brat son.
He doesn't look like a spoiled rich kid.
He was, not so long ago. Went off and did the army or something. Came back and just went out into the woods. Must be nice.
Must be nice? You'd lose your mind out there. You can't go 5 minutes without butting in on some conversation.
It'd be a lot easier if I was well off like him. Just saying.
You know, you're always just saying, and yet you never have anything good to say.
I don't have to sit here and take your shit.
I'm going to the bathroom. Lance.
Frank Olson.
I know. Just got an earful about you from my asshole buddy.
I remember Gary as being a hell of a ball player back in high school.
Yep. From what I heard, he was one of the best. Now he's got child support to pay. Septic tanks to pump. A real ugly girlfriend that lives two towns over.
Could be worse.
One thing he's got going for him is being his own boss. And the fact that his girlfriend's got a yoga body, as he likes to put it.
Mm-hmm.
I got plans to do the same one of these days.
Get your next beer for a smoke.
Well, you got yourself a deal, Mountain Man.
I need this.
Sometimes it's the little things. Smoking a cheap beer can take miles off a man.
First day of the season yesterday.
I don't get out there like I used to. It's been years, actually. How'd your first day go?
Landed my permit.
Hey, you got one. Now what?
Still work to do.
I should get out there this year.
You can come walk my land if you want. I'll show you a good spot.
Nah. I ain't got the time.
Well, if you're worried about embarrassing yourself, you know, I promise to go easy on you when you whiff every shot. There's nothing wrong with being a pussy when it comes to hunting. It's not for everyone.
Pussy, huh?
It's not for everyone.
What time you want me there?
Early morning's best for big bucks, but we could do afternoon if you need time to primp and groom.
You done for the night?
Early to bed, early to rise. I got his too.
You come back soon.
I may be a bit hungover tomorrow.
And believe me, the cold morning air will clear that right up. I'm on the dirt road just off Lawson, all the way to the end. Can't miss it.
I know the area.
Yeah, plenty of kids spent nights parked on those roads.
Jesus, God Almighty. You're out here every year?
All year.
Sounds goddamn exhausting.
Well, always something to be done. You know, something to consume a man.
Well, you gotta make money.
Come on. Still got a ways to go.
Been out in the woods in a bit.
Yep. I feel like that's most folks these days. Yeah, living their lives at home, never having to acknowledge that the natural world's still out here. The real thing that gets missed is out here. Every move you make changes the move something else is gonna make. Yeah, your scent changes the path of the game. Your footsteps break apart leaves and twigs, making them decompose faster. Everything has an impact.
Living out in the backwoods is like earning a degree in philosophy.
Everyone makes their own choices. I made mine as much as you made yours. And they all sit in judgment of the way they decide to live, but it doesn't matter what the verdict is. They're always going to have to live with the consequences.
Let's head up the hill that way.
Steep hike that way.
I got a good feeling about it.
Never been one to argue with a gut feeling.
I haven't hiked this much in forever.
There's a good opening up ahead.
See? Gotta trust my gut.
See, everything in the woods has a choice to make. And most of the time, it's the path of least resistance. But the scents they smell, the prints they see, they can block that path. A single owl could change a route that's been used forever. Everything has a choice to make. Like right now, we make ours.
Yeah.
see. Got it.
Nice shot, motherfucker! Yeah! Fuck yeah, that shit was awesome! Yeah! That's what I'm talking about. You like that? You like that?
Jesus. Good shot.
Just shy of a kill shot.
Well, it's always good to have a pro to put in that second shot, just to be sure. Whew. Forgot how much of a rush that was, huh? Bet you it reminds you of the war.
Ever field dress?
I never have, no. Old man would take it home, bleed it, and skin it.
Go find us a sapling. Right, a little taller than you, as thick as your wrist. Needs to bend, not snap, so something's still green in the center.
To be a pussy about it. I have to be a fucking pussy about it. Fucking pussy. Alright, Lance.
There's plenty out here that'll eat that right up.
Good for them. It smells like shit.
Grab that end.
How far out are we?
About a mile and a half. Ready? 3, 2, lift.
Let me be honest with you, I got a business proposition. Try not to tell anybody, but I gotta pay a business.
Now to decide whether you want to take it home with you or not. There's a butcher for you.
You'd be the pro, so if you're willing to butcher it for me, I'm willing to give you any cuts you want to keep.
I'll take care of it.
Appreciate that. Beer? God, yes. It's a hell of a place.
It's been in my family for over a century. My family used to have a lot of pride in where we came from.
Not anymore?
I feel like it skipped a generation. I had to restore the place from the ground up.
Be honest with you, I know a little something about building something yourself. I got a business proposition for you.
You know, my grandpa built this cabin. He was in search of solitude. And he just came back from the Korean War and started right in on a family and a business. I wanted the same solitude after my service. Different reasons. You know, I did my job, I followed my orders, but here I could pursue a life outside the noise of the world. These woods just are. They don't need much.
Sounds to me like you're hiding from yourself out here. Like some kind of punishment. What was it? You killed a few people in combat and you enjoyed it? And it shocked you? What you can do to your fellow man without any guilt? Did it make you feel like some kind of an asshole? The thing you missed is, you're not the only asshole, we all are. Every goddamn one of us, fucking and fighting and trying to get our due, because it's owed us. But only if you take it. And instead of having the courage to live your life, you came out here and you hid from all the assholes. And it's a sad thing. That your hiding place is going to be your resting place. All because you had to teach another asshole a lesson. And for what?